Recent images of the Chinese People's Liberation Army Air Force's J-16 multirole fighter jet, equipped with the long-range PL-17 upgraded air-to-air missile, were made public. Four J-16 jet flying in formation are seen in the photo, each carrying a different arrangement of air-to-air missiles. Two of them have their rifles ready to fire. Four PL-10 missiles, one PL-12, four PL-15s, and one larger PL-17 missile appear to be aboard the two J-16s in question. The J-16's combat range, which spans short to long range, is covered by its varied missile loadout. With the PL-17 missile, its shooting range is increased even more. It wasn't until November 2016, during a test firing 7 years ago, that the PL-17, also known as the PL-20, was seen. The missile was first referred to by the West as the PLXX. Targeting high-value assets like tankers and enemy airborne early warning and reconnaissance (AEW&C) jet is probably the main purpose of this long-range missile. The PL-17 project seems to have been planned as a replacement for the fighter jet, powered PL-12 or PL-21 models. With its dual-pulse rocket motor, the PL-17 is simpler to operate technologically than the PL-15 long-range missile, but at about 6 meters in length, it is also wider in diameter. The missile maneuvers by utilizing thrust vector control in conjunction with four tiny tail fins. The PL-17 missile is said to have a maximum speed of at least Mach 4 and a range of more than 300 kilometers. Its guiding is anticipated to be accomplished by combining an ESA seeker, which is extremely resistant to electronic countermeasures, with a two-way data link. It would be far more difficult to defeat if the missile had an optical window on its nose side, as this would reveal the presence of an additional infrared seeker that would not be susceptible to jamming during the last stages of conflict. The J-16 with its PL-17 missile is anticipated to use targeting data supplied by current assets to engage an opponent at a considerable distance during a combat. These assets could be satellites, ground-based radar, other jet in closer proximity to the target, or even airborne early warning and control jet.